I'm just back from South by Southwest. I presented the Design and Tech Report 2025. Let's go through a 5-minute super fast supercut of it. Stay tuned. Every year I give a report at South by Southwest at the intersection of design and tech. I want to give you some excerpts, specifically, what the heck are agents? And how did this come to be? And what's cool out there? Ready? Let's go. Okay, so first off, this is, I was sitting in the hotel restaurant, looking out the window, noticing this scene. And I thought it was interesting because if you can see here, it's spelling something. And I thought, hey, I'm a human. I know what that spells. But I asked GPT-4o what it thought. And I didn't think it would get it right, but it nailed it, Courtyard Marriott. And I want to note that this word, likely. Likely is the word of the cozy AI revolution. It's not 100% right. It can say it's likely. And that has changed the whole game because all computer science was about determinism, but now it's non-deterministic. Likely is a good thing. Add to that, open source AI is off the charts. I used to keep track of this in the reports. This is 2018 number of GitHub repos, 94K machine learning, 28K deep learning, 10.5K AI. It's now 1.7 million for AI. That's a lot of code out there. But most importantly, for the chefs out there and the cooks out there, it's a chance to learn. So much code. On top of that, it's cheaper to use AI. If you look at just in 1 year, token costs have dropped by down to a tenth, if not more. It means that everything you thought was too expensive to do, it's now easy to do, so no better time than ever than to cook with AI. Now, I was also keeping track of voice technology advances because around 2012, the whole world of speech was revolutionized when GPUs were introduced into the process flow and made voice sound much better. Let's hear iOS 9 in 2015.
1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces.
Let's hear in 2016.
1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces.
If you notice, not a big deal. But 2017.
1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces.
Sounds a lot better, right? And now in 2024, OpenAI's Alloy.
1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces.
Pretty good. But then Sesame is unusual.
1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces.
Can you say it in a way that would surprise someone that it's coming from an AI?
You won't believe this, but 1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces. Mind blown.
Can you say it again?
Okay, brace yourself. 1 liter is 33.81 fluid ounces. I can say it again and again if you'd like. It's kind of hypnotic, don't you think?
And that's less than a 10-year span of time. So 2025, special year. You know we carried around the bricks in the cozy AI kitchen? We call them models. Call them agents instead. So replace all your in your mind. When people say models, just blurt out agents. We're in the agent era. Secondly, the loop component is what's making agents exciting. Why? Because agents are just computer programs. And as you know, computer programs at rest aren't a big deal. But they run in a server, in a loop, wow, they're amazing. Think FTP of the 1990s, no one cared about it. But once you put it in a server, so-called web server, off the charts. So an agent is that reckoning of that web-like moment. Now, there's all kind of UX shifts in the on-screen and even off-screen, but chat is here to stay. Now, I noticed that there were people saying that AI chat is really easy to identify. They were saying like, oh, you know, the way chat works, it's always one human, one AI, they take turns. I just want to show you that is easily debunked. Hello there. I'm doing great. It's warm here. Notice that I'm saying three things, and the AI is saying a few things as well, and I can say, hey, nice to see you. So this idea that there's something you can identify as AI-like or not is rapidly changing, so don't believe that. So chat is everywhere, and it's going to be very hard to detect if it's a human or not. Number two, documents are changing. The notion of what we type can be changed into all kinds of things. This is work by Tyler Engert, where he's typing a document and is taking apart all the different pieces so you can analyze your text and do like a zoomed out view while you're typing at the same time. This is a beautiful example of adding a color picker for words by Matthew Hsu. I want to make it more disgusting. I want to make it more fearful. And so this is a weird way to work with words, but this is possible because of our favorite in the kitchen, semantic code, the semantic era. And I have a whole bunch of other examples I'll put online. Tables are big. You may have seen the other episode on spreadsheets. I love spreadsheets because tables are the greatest interface for lots of data. And so table AI is off the charts as well. You'll see this kind of spreadsheet-like AI pattern everywhere. And lastly, infinite canvases. This is a work by Samuel Timbo, where we're making different kind of visual programming interfaces on infinite canvases. Those of you from the 70s and 80s will remember we tried to do this. There was a popular MIDI system for that. Now it's becoming much more common. This is by Amelia Wattenberger. It's the way she organizes her emails on an infinite canvas. So just imagine waking up in the morning and like really organizing your life, your work, like a giant creative canvas. So that's this way. And if you haven't seen TL Draw, you gotta check it out. This report's super long, so I'm just going over a section of the first chapter, loop. This is Shar, a media researcher at the Media Lab. I'm gonna dedicate my thesis on creative coding to loop. So the beginning just says for loop. Kind of cute, huh? The young people. Now, what is a loop? For me, the loop changed my life because in the 1970s, I was able to see my first computer. And my first computer, some of you will remember this, but it looked kind of like this. It was total green screen. And the first program you learn when you approach this computer is to print your name. Let me print Ross's name. Ross is a co-producer of The Kitchen here. So I'm going to 10 and then go to 10. And if I run that, I mean, Ross is feeling very validated now. So that's a moment, right? But after you learn that program and you get kind of cooler, my friend showed me how, like, oh, John, just do this. Print Ross space, comma, 20, go to 10. And then, wow, right? Now, think about it. It's in a loop. It's never going to stop. That's weird. And so just want to note that computers have this ability to be never, ever tired. And now imagine putting an agent in a loop and, wow, stuff's going to happen. What is an agent? An agent has four ingredients. The model, the brick we know from the kitchen, the prompts, we've learned about that, knowledge to ground it from files, from databases, and tools, APIs, to reach out and touch something. Now, I want to note that agents, when they are either looping or they're sleeping, but they're all computation, like the Billy Joel song, all rock and roll to me. Okay, agents are very similar to object-oriented programming. Those of you who remember OOP coming out, super confusing. What's a classes? What's methods? What are these things? We can do a direct one-to-one sort of overlap of models are classes, knowledge is object properties, actions are methods. And so everyone relax because it's just a different kind of programming and we're used to changing how we program. This is a new way. What is an agent four ways? Let's review again. 2023 definition by Lillian Wang. Agent is a model with memory, planning skills, and tools. But I want to note that in 2025, because token costs went down, you could stick them in a loop. Those of you who remember 2 years ago, GPT-4 tokens were like platinum. You couldn't get them. So you would never stick your agent in a loop because it'd be too expensive and also take too long. So now we're in an era where token costs are down, agents are on fleek because they're in a loop. And last, I want to end with this. Steve Jobs in 1984 actually said, well, the types of computers we have today are tools, they're responders. You ask a computer to do something and it will do it. The next stage is going to be computers as agents. So anyways, that was a quick overview of one section of the Design and Tech Report. If you want to read more, it's going to be somewhere online. Cozy AI Kitchen is dedicated to enabling you to be in the loop with the agents ahead of everyone else so you can stay competitive and cook delicious meals. Let's stay tuned and see you next episode. Bye-bye.